The push for gender diversity in Singapore's top 100 listed companies has yielded some results. More women are being represented on corporate boards, increasing from just over 12% in 2017 to about 16% today. However, it's still a long way from reaching a target of 20% by year's end, as Michelle Teo reports.
The DAC has a triple-tiered target of 20% of women on boards by 2020, 25% by 2025, and 30% by 2030.
That was Minister Grace Fu reiterating the goals of the Diversity Action Committee in 2018. That year ended with women's participation on boards at 15.2%. Since 2017, the number has been increasing steadily, but some sectors are lagging behind their industry peers.
The mainstream real estate companies have been doing particularly well. I would say the telecommunication company are also doing very well. I think that this is also probably because of the market segments they serve. Many of their clients, their customers are of both genders. But for the real estate investment trust or REITs, they actually have many of the trusts that have not even a single woman on the board.
Non-profit organizations say that's due in part to the way successions are structured.
A lot of them have told us that they aren't able to find capable women, the lack of capable women, and so we've been telling them that really they need to look to renew their boards and not to replace them. It's through renewal that we are able to get in new blood, new thoughts, new skills, and that's where the board and the company can really grow and flourish.
To achieve the 20% by end 2020 goal, 37 more women directors need to be on board. Analysts say reaching this target is a challenge. However, they say Singapore should not be fixated on chasing a number.
The most important thing is actually at the company level. We have to make sure that they see that it is in their business advantage to have women on board, that it helps in the progress of the business. The last thing we want is to have women on board for the sake of having women, and I think this is a phenomenon that many people say, tokenism, that you do it for the sake of doing it and you actually don't believe in it.
On its part, Board Agenda is helping to introduce more women leaders to companies.
A lot of them could be entrepreneurs. They can avail themselves to be on boards, having run their own company as well. So these are good areas and avenues to tap on. So you don't have to always look for someone who has risen through the corporate, the rungs.
In a bid to increase women participation on boards, the Monetary Authority of Singapore has also put in place a 9-year cap for independent directors. This takes effect from 2022.